Welcome to Man vs. Fire. A construction crew has cut a major gas line.
Approximately a 3-inch main running through.
When Captain Buddy Atkins arrives on the scene, the acrid smell of natural gas and an ominous hissing sound permeate the summer heat.
Engine 206's crew has deployed an 1¾-inch attack line or safety line in the event of a flash fire.
If I dive on the ground, you're late if you're not joining me.
A crew from the power company arrives to assess and repair the damage. Like the engine crew, as a precaution, they suit up in flame retardant suits. With the gas main venting so much volume, the slightest spark could set off a tsunami of flame. For firefighters and police, keeping vehicles and pedestrians out of the danger zone is priority one.
A gentleman just walked up within a close proximity of the actual gas leak, and this intelligent individual is actually smoking a cigarette.
The power company plans to tap into the main on either side of the leak to install a temporary bypass line above ground. The sweltering heat has already been making things tough, and now the wind shifts. Levels of natural gas around the engine rise dangerously. They'll have to move.
We're going to back up.
Let's go! That's a gas leak right there. You might catch on fire if you're too close.
Once they move the engine and reposition the line, the firefighters are ready. Despite the busting up of concrete, the workers remain cautious.
We're relocating a pickup truck that has vital equipment on it. Because it was located in the leak area, we could not crank the truck to drive it over here. So it's being manually pushed into a safer area. The fire hose that's on the ground is deployed. It is charged, ready for service. It is set up in an accordion. That accordion can be deployed kink-free at a moment's notice. Also, my crew is now in a shady spot, hoping nothing happens at this point.
The rehab van arrives, providing cool water for some hot firefighters. But they're not the only ones who want to enjoy the cool water.
Excuse me. Probably wouldn't be a good idea to continue swimming.
There's a major gas leak that's going on right now.
All right, thank you.
Another young woman decides to go around the police and over the hose.
Unbelievable.
A move that could have seriously injured a firefighter. Because she was in such a hurry, she'll now have to wait until after the scene is clear before she can move her car. If you think she's not happy now, just wait until she pays the $500 fine. Finishing up here will take another hour, but we won't make you wait that long. The repair was finished, and the young woman, well, she learned her lesson and walked away with a smile. No fine, this time.
Engine 209, assignment complete. Be going back to ops.
The forecast for most of the summer is hot as hell and liable to rain. Today's scorcher turns into a downpour. Firefighters spend the afternoon chasing down small fires. Lightning strikes a residence, leaving no trace of entry, but takes out the microwave oven.
Hit there, melted, and there's our mark on the bottom.
Curious to find out what the melting temperature is to make that hole and to melt it like that.
Next, a fire in a laundry room.
All right, we received a call for a possible residential fire in the Pepper Hill subdivision. We had several engines responding. The homeowner actually did a good job knocking the flames down. Wasn't exactly enough. Trying to talk to the citizens about storing objects near a water heater, such as lawnmowers or gas cans. But in this instance right here, it's believed that it was a dryer that started the fire. The fire really could have got out of hand, but I'm glad she called us when she did.
Even when the day seems done, it's not. Despite warnings like this one, stove fires are common.
Immediately when the grease hit the bottom of the microwave and just combusted, started fire, I just immediately thought to go and put it out right then.
Threw some salt water on it.
Right now the firemen are removing the stove. The stove was part of the hazard. Right there. Do it to what you want. At the same time, just, you know, checking around the residence. As you can see right there, it's where smoke alone more, but it's not up now.
The victim's mom lives in an identical unit.
See how low the microwave is?
you cannot adjust the knob unless you move the pot over, and I feel like it's too low.
A neighbor has had a similar experience.
So what happened was, I have a Band-Aid. Actually, it looks pretty bad. I actually had to cover it, but it actually like went all the way through my skin the first time I got burnt, and it was through some oil. So tonight, this is another example of like what happened. Like a fire broke loose because the fire pops, and it's really close.
Although his kitchen is ruined, there is a bright side.
I'm just looking at it, this is a blessing because I didn't get burned or nothing.
We saw how lightning melted tempered glass. How hot did it have to get? 500, 1100, or 2000 degrees Fahrenheit? The answer when Man vs. Fire returns.